5, they did nothing to challenge or resist. In heaven, his throne is made of gold. The ark of his testament is stowed. A throne from which I'm told all history does unfold. It's made of wood and wire, and my body is on fire. And God is never far away. Into the mercy seat I climb. My head is shaved, my head is wired. And
Johnny Cash, Mr. Johnny Cash, doing a cover of Nick Cave's The Mercy Seat. Some singular voices, those, eh? And indeed, Mr. Cash's voice was raised most heavenward. Without the irony or the stinging twist that Mr. Cave always sticks to his words. We are here at stage 4 of how to get yourself into right relationship with God. I can offer no more important teaching or advice from what little I have learned on my still yet oh-so-brief and really in its finality still oh-so-brief pilgrimage of flesh in this life. But this, by far the most important thing I've learned. Number 4, now throw yourself on the mercy of the cross. Borrowing from a Song of Mary here, Luke 1:50, and his mercy is on those who fear him from generation to generation. And everything before now has been in preparation for this. Even repentance is a turning away from self, leaving and identifying and confessing all that you're leaving behind in this turning around. With that bow down spirit without and within, and indeed throw yourself on the mercy of the cross. Throw yourself at the feet of the throne. All that you are is broken and abused and lost and separated from its sole purpose, its sole purpose, which is to be part and parcel of the glory of God. You are called to worship and delight and congress with your Creator. That was all of our created intention, and we fill that up, that need up, that design up, with so many distractions. Lay it all down at the mercy seat. The mercy seat was one you could, it was in the temple, and that's what you could run to and grasp a hold of if you were fleeing judgment from men, or armies, or what have you. Grab hold of the horns of this, built into this thing, that you might attain mercy from God. And thusly you are doing so in the privacy of your own home or wherever you are. You are fleeing from all the destruction that lays within and without you. And reaching out and grasping hold and laying everything within you down. All those burdens you have repented of, you lay them down. And entreat Christ not with only with your words out loud, but your very being, your soul, your ego, your personality. Lay it all down. That it might be healed, removed. And again, if this any part of the process leads you on through the rest of it by his divine guidance, then follow his divine guidance far, far more than my own. But beware your own mind. Beware your own fleshly instincts, which will do anything it can to tell you that you are this solution. It will do anything it can to tell you that you need not do these things. But all these things that you do and are to lay down are useful to you. I tell you that nothing is useful to you if it is not useful to Him. I'm going to read one other verse that I just really thought spoke beautifully to this from Psalm 123:1-9, and one through two. I'm actually probably going to read this tomorrow for tomorrow's step as well. Unto thee lift I up mine eyes, O thou that dwellest in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look unto the hand of their masters, and as the eyes of a maiden unto the hand of her mistress, so our eyes wait upon the Lord our God, until that He have mercy upon us. The Lord delights to deliver mercy to those who fear Him. Lay yourself out, lay yourself bare. He is but a hair's breadth away, if not moving in you already. Blessings to you in this most enlightening of journeys. Peace be unto you. Amen. And Selah.
Done!